Team coverage continues right now. A double dose of winter has descended on Connecticut. First, dangerous snow squalls, and now we are preparing for cold that could really be life-threatening. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Matthew Campbell has been out and about in Weather Tracker 1 all night, and he has a look at the roads right now. Matthew? All right, he's coming, I'm told.
It came in an instant and was gone in minutes. This is time-lapse video of snow squalls hitting Waterbury during rush hour.
Snow. A lot of snow. Just came out of nowhere.
Linda Tran was out when the squall swept through. She says snow started falling like normal, but then it was like someone flipped a switch and it started dumping.
Couldn't see nothing. It was bad.
She ended up pulling over out of caution and waited around 10 minutes for it to pass. The squalls were coming through at around 40 miles an hour, paralyzing traffic in its wake. And even now, hours later, danger lingers. The slush after the squalls has now frozen over, and as temperatures drop, the DOT will have a tough time getting the roads clear. They explain that regular salt loses its power when we get into the single digits, so crews put down liquid magnesium chloride to get the job done.
When we add liquid magnesium chloride to that mixture, the effectiveness of the salt is still reasonably good down into the single-digit temperature range.
But they warn even that won't guarantee safety, and that's why Governor Ned Lamont is activating the severe cold weather protocol.
Because this is a very dangerous time for some folks. What we're doing otherwise is on the roads, we're putting down this certain compound that'll make sure the snow doesn't stick as much.
Warming centers will be open for the homeless or for those who experience heating emergencies. The record-setting cold coming from the Midwest even had one Missouri police department pleading with criminals not to commit crimes for their own safety and the safety of officers. Suffield Police is extending that plea to everyone tomorrow.
The more people that are putting themselves at risk out on the road, you're forcing our staff to come to you.
Now, police also say that one of the most popular emergency calls during a cold snap is for power outages. They advise Eversource or United Illuminated be your first call, not police. They say that just ties up their lines. We're live here in Weather Tracker 1 tonight. Matthew Campbell, Channel 3.